Hello everyone, welcome to another session of design pattern in Go. In this session, we'll understand the builder design pattern. So I will first explain you the theory part of it, then I will explain it programmatically, and the program that I will explain here will be present. The GitHub link for that program will be present in the description part of this video. Now let's start with the what of the builder design pattern. So builder design pattern aims to separate the construction of complex objects from its representation so that the same construction process can create the different representations. It is used to construct a complex object step by step, and the final step will be returned in a Reta will return the object. So basically, builder pattern says that if you have a complex object, just separate the creation of that object into a step-by-step process so that the whole step should be created as a final product. Now, when we implement the builder design pattern, there are three main characteristics of the builder pattern. The first one is called the product. Product is actually the complex object that has to be generated. Second one is the builder. Builder is the object that defines all of the steps that must be taken in order to correctly create the product. Now, finally, the director. Director controls the algorithm that generates the final product object. Now, let's come to the why of the builder design pattern. So when we have to create or build a complex object, then we use the builder design pattern. So one real-time example of builder design pattern is the DOM creation. See, we know that whenever a DOM is created, then a lot of nodes and attributes and properties related to those attributes and nodes are created on the fly. So since it's a very, very complex process, then builder pattern can be used here. Now, let me explain you the how of the builder pattern. So to explain you the how of the builder pattern, I will explain you by taking an example of constructing a house, and house will be the final end product that will be returned as an output, and it will have many steps like building walls, building doors, etc. And finally, the whole house object will be created step by step and returned to the colony. So first, I will explain you two programs. One program will be a simple program to make you understand the builder pattern, and then I will make the same program a bit of a complex to make you understand the builder pattern. Now, let me start writing the program. Here is, first I will say package main, then I will import a package fmt, because I will use the println or the printf method of this fmt package to display the output to the console. Then there is an struct called house builder. Let me create this struct. Now, this struct has multiple properties like window. This is of type string, then it will have door. This is of type string, then it can have wall and say number of floors. It is of type integer. Now, once the house builder struct is created, now let's write a function called get house builder. Now, what it will do is it will return the instance of the house builder, and it will say return house builder. Now, once this function is here, let's write some receiver function on this house builder. Now, let's say I'm writing function. And since it's a receiver function, so it will receive an argument to house builder, and the name of the function is say build window. And once the build window is called, it will return a pointer to house builder, and build window will say, it will say b dot window. It will tell us the window type. It will say the window is wooden window, and it will finally return the whole house builder instance. Now, in a similar way, let's write down four functions: build window, build door, build wall, and build number of floors, and every one of it will be the receiver function. Let's say build door. Now it will say door, and I will say iron doors. Now the third one should be build wall, and should be wall. I'll say concrete wall. Now the fourth receiver function should say build number of floors, and I'll say number of floors. So since it's an integer property, I'll say number of floors should be 2. So what I've done here is I have created a struct with certain properties, now created multiple methods to set each and every property of that specific struct. Now let me write down the main method here. So I'll say function, it's the main method. And now here I will say house, get new house builder. And now see, there are two things. Now, if I were to set the properties of this house builder struct, either I can set the property in one go, but since setting the properties can be a complex process, so I have separated the setting of each properties into each and every of the receiver functions. And now I will build these properties or set these properties one by one. So this is how what I'm doing is I'm creating my complex object, that is house builder, step by step, and I'm making sure that this object is created successfully. Now how I'm doing that is I will say house dot, I will say build door. Now by calling build door, what I have done is I have set a property called iron window, that is called door. Right. Now I will say dot build window dot build say wall dot build number of floors. So basically what I have done is for constructing a house, I have segregated the house into 4 different properties, and I am creating that house object one by one by setting the properties, each and every property in a step-by-step manner. So this is a very, very simple example of builder pattern of what exactly we do within the builder pattern. Now let's do one thing is, I'll say fmt.println and I will print the house here. And after I have set the properties, I will again do fmt.println and I will print the house. So first, since this is a blank house, so this will print nothing. And after I have set it, the properties, all the properties here, so it will print all the properties of the house here. Now let me run go run main.go. You see, first it is blank. It is instantiating as 0 because number of floors is integer. Integer default is 0. And after that, it has set all the properties here. So this is a very, very basic example of what exactly a builder pattern is. Now, let me make this program a bit of a complex. So I have already written down the program for you to make it easier or to save time here. Let me quickly remove it and paste the program here. So now in here, as I've explained that there are 3 characteristics of the builder pattern: product, builder, and director. So I've introduced all 3 characteristics here now. So what I've done is I have made 2 structs here. So the house builder is same as it was in the previous program, but there is a replica of the house builder struct called house with all the same properties at this house is containing. Now there is a function called get house builder that is returning the instance or the blank instance of this house builder. All other methods are same. These are the receiver function to set each and every property of the house builder struct. So the program is exactly same. Now there is additional receiver method that I have added to this house builder struct. Now this is called the build house. What exactly it is doing is it is returning an instance of a struct house that I have created above, and it is setting the properties of this struct house with the properties of the house builder that I am setting in the above functions and returning that. This is needed because we have introduced a director here. Now, director will not be able to return the instance of the builder. So we have introduced a new struct called house where we are setting the property of the house builder and then returning it. Now, I have introduced a director here. Now, what exactly director does it? It directs that how we should build the complex process step by step. Now, there's a method called new director that's returning the instance of a new director with the house builder set in it. The benefit of instantiating this director with the property of builder is whenever we'll instantiate a director with the property of a builder, it will have all the members attached to the house builder struct automatically within it, and it will be make able to make use of the methods and the members of the house builder. Now there's a method called build house in the director. That's the receiver functions attached to the director struct that is directing how my house should be created. You see, it is saying build wall on the house builder, then build door, setting the property of door, build window, setting window, build number of house, setting number of house. Finally, it is saying build house. Now from here, the director will not be able to return the home builder instance or the house builder instance. That's why we have introduced the house here. And within the house, we are setting the properties of the house builder to the struct house and returning it back from here. Now in the main method, I am saying get me a house builder. So basically I'm getting a blank instance of a struct house builder. I have passed that struct to the director constructor, where I have created a new director. Using this, what has happened is all the properties of the house builder struct are now present in the director. Now I am saying director dot build house. That means director build my house now. So now director in the building house, it is doing okay. Director has a property called builder, and builder is actually the house builder here. This has a method called build wall that will be called automatically, and it will set the property of the wall. This will set the property of door, then windows, then number of floors, and finally build house will be called. And in the build house, I will set all the properties of this house builder that I have set in these methods, and then finally will return the house back. And here I'm checking what are the properties values that I have set here. So you see here, now as the name indicates, this is the director. Now this house is the product. And this house builder is the builder. Product because we want to build a house. Builder because it is explaining me step by step of how my house will be created, because it has segregated that into multiple parts and giving me a function related to each and every property. Now director, because it is directing me of how it should be created or how my complex object will be created. Now let me run this program for you to show you whether it is working or not. You see, it says normal hall wall house is wooden wall. Now house door will be wooden door. House window will be wooden window, and number of floor will be 2. In this floor, everything is wooden. That's why it is saying this. Now, this is all about the builder design pattern in Go. Now, the program related to this of whatever I have shown you will be present in the GitHub repository. That's the part of the description part of this video. Please do like, subscribe, and comment if you really like my video. And please don't forget to press the bell icon so that you do not miss the new videos related to the design pattern in Go. Thank you very much, guys.